you're an empathetic person and you experience mood swings very often, maybe you feel distressed or angry or sad, the weather makes you sad, or you had a stressful day, or I don't know, some person said something stupid and you took it personally. Like, you just have a bad day, you feel down for some reason, maybe you don't even know why that is. I mean, it happens to the best of us, right? But there's something that you can do against it. There's something that you can do to actually be happy again. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Elena, and on my channel you'll find like everything related to spirituality, psychology a bit, entertainment, a bit of music, a bit of tarot. But today we're gonna talk about like feelings, like maybe feelings that are like associated as negative feelings, like everything that you don't want to feel, sadness, anger, grief. Is stress a feeling? I don't know. Feeling stress, I feel stressed very often. Feeling annoyed by the people in general around me, or by the weather. Like with us, we had like a couple of days just rain, and it's gonna rain on for at least two more days, and it's just annoying. When I have this kind of low episodes, or I see that I have been feeling down for a while now, and it's just it keeps like really affecting my life because I feel down, I just try to like, I start to attract things that are not in my best interest. I start to like, you know, some kind of chain reaction that just goes on, and things keep happening to me, and I'm just like, you know, I really didn't need this today, this is not my kind of day. And then, you know, this just and you know, there's actually something that you can do about it, you know, staying on like a high frequency and a high vibration frequency. It's gonna help you to actually feel better. Like, the secret to happiness is actually, you know, it's a choice, it's not really like a secret. And there's some things that you can do to feel better, to feel happier, to feel just high. Being high vibrational, having like a high frequency, being happy, it's gonna attract you more things to be happy because of than to be happy about. Every time we talk about the law of mirroring, the law of attraction, the law of assumption, it's always about, you know, things that you put out there, they come back, and how you are, like the way you are, this is what you're gonna experience, this is what the world is gonna give you back. And if you are happy, if you're feeling happy, if you're feeling good, then everything around you will keep you in the state of feeling good, feeling happy. This is what we want, right? So there are actually some things that you can do to raise your vibrations, to instantly feel better if you feel down. I would not recommend you, like, I'm a big music fan, and I listen to music every day, like at least half the day, and this is the first thing to know about, like, listen to music can raise your vibrations, but it doesn't, like, it shouldn't be sad music. If you're like me and you're one of this these people who, you know, if you're sad, you start to listen to sad music because it just vibes with you. Maybe because of the aesthetic, who knows, but it's not helpful. It's gonna increase the sadness in the worst case. So the best thing that you can do is to feel like, to listen to music that makes you happy, to listen to like quick beats, to listen to happy music. I for myself, I have like a happy playlist. I have like a very long happy playlist on Spotify or iTunes. You can do it like wherever you want, like whatever you prefer, but like a happy playlist with songs that instantly keep you, you know, on your feet, keep you dancing, keep you moving, keep you singing even, that's beautiful. And you should have something like that, because if you like music and you like being happy, then you can only just listen to this playlist if you feel down, and you're gonna feel better. If you like singing, if these songs make you sing along, this is like even better, because then you're not only raising your vibrations to these quick beats to these happy frequencies. You can also sing it out. Like every feeling that you pushed down, everything that you didn't want to feel, maybe you have suppressed them, maybe you subconsciously got triggered or anything that day, and that's why you're feeling low, but you don't know really why. So maybe this is the reason that you pushed it down, and then you can just, you can get rid of it this way. You can sing it out. Or you can dance it out. Like if these songs make you dance, dance. Like any kind of movement is gonna like make you happy too. It's gonna make you feel better. This is where we are at the second thing that you can do to feel better instantly, is to move your body. This is what Master Shri Akashan always says, like first thing in the morning, that you have to get your body moving, like get the energies flowing. Moving your body, like going for a run or going for a jog or going for like a little walk, or just dancing, moving, jumping around, I don't know, whatever you do, doing some sports, playing with some friends, this is gonna like instantly make you feel better, because it also gets your like serotonin going, it gets your adrenaline going, and woo! The thing that you can do is like think about personal things that make you happy, like eating a good meal, for example, or going out into the sun. I mean, if it's raining, like it's raining, you know, at my place right now, then that's not possible, of course, but maybe, I don't know, watch a movie, do something that you know that you will enjoy and that will make you feel better. I mean, these all seem like quick fixes, but actually, like whatever gets you into higher vibrations, gets you into higher frequencies, also allows you to expand your perspective, to expand your horizons, and to see things a bit more logical, a bit more clearly. Because if you are looking at your life, looking at your day, looking at things, whatever the situation is, from like a low view, from a low point, then you won't see the complete truth. Obviously, it will always be like a shadow on it. So if you are getting yourself into like a happier place, then you know, you might even, you know, be able to find a solution to the problem that you have, or you know, figure out why you're feeling down. It just makes you feel more clear. It gives you the chance to, you know, restructure yourself. What you can also do is like talk about it, like whatever is bringing you down, you can talk with a close friend or with a family member. Someone we know will listen to you and won't judge you for the feelings that you have. They will validate your feelings and they will listen to you. This is extremely important, because if you talk to someone and they make you feel invalid, like your feelings are not validated when you talk to them, then it's not gonna feel like, it's not gonna make you feel better or anything actually. But like talking to someone that makes you happy, then do that. Like this is a good thing to do. I always call my best friend when I'm feeling really low, because I know she's gonna listen, and I know I will always be able to talk to her about stuff like that, and I will maybe not feel instantly happy, but I will feel better. I mean, it also really depends on why you're feeling down, why you're feeling sad, what you're feeling really, but I'm just here to give you suggestions, and you can choose whatever you want to do to feel happy. Another great tip is to, you know, change into something that makes you feel comfortable. Like put something on, like your favorite outfit, your favorite jewelry, your favorite hairstyle, like do something with yourself, paint your nails, something that makes you feel more comfortable about yourself, makes you feel confident and self-aware. Because you know, it takes you back to yourself, to your own body. It makes you more present, because when you're like all in your mind and but maybe you're even dissociating and not really present in the moment, and just, you know, doing some practical things for yourself, like some self-care, like take a bath, don't listen to the siren. This is just, it happens every 5 minutes in my city. Someone gets sick. Don't get sick. Do little things for yourself that make you feel more self-aware. It's gonna bring you back to your own emotions, to your own feelings, to your own body. And it will also bring you clarity about what to do next, what it's best for you right now to make you feel better on this particular day, in this particular situation. Another thing is when you feel like you're really stuck in a situation or you need a solution to a problem, we tend, like as human beings, we tend to first find someone to blame, you know, find someone to put the blame on too. Because, you know, then we have someone who's responsible. But instead, focus on the solution. Like, don't ask for the why and why is it happening to me. It's not happening to you. It's happening for you. Like, nothing is happening to hurt you. Like, everything is either a lesson or a challenge or a miracle, a blessing, whatever. But nothing is here to hurt you. You're just supposed to learn from the things that happen for you. Like, don't ask for why did it happen, don't ask for who is to blame. Just, you know, these are all just hurdles. You can walk right through them and think, okay, what can I do about it? You know, just go straight to the solution and don't mind the blaming. They have already 5 things that you can do to instantly make you feel better, and there's like so much more. Like, the list is endless. I'm sure everybody has hobbies, every one of you has activities and things to do that you enjoy and that you like and that will instantly make you feel happier. It's not about like quick fixes, it's not about pretending that you're happy to actually be happy. It's about finding things that make you happy right now, because happiness is not something that you chase. It's not something that will be there eventually in the future. It's not something that you can achieve. It's literally a choice. At least that's my point of view. And I just thought maybe if you like agree with that, or if you see where I was going with that, that it's actually easier for you to look at this whole happiness secret thing, because it doesn't seem so complicated anymore. It's not something you earn, it's something that you just do, it's something that you just decide. So this was my video for today, a quick education video on happiness. I'm surely not a master at this. I have my down days as well, and it's really, really strongly raining right now. It's pouring. But just filming this video just made me happy again, because I have to be happy for you guys, and I'm happy. Just smiling, you know, is another great tip. It's an extra tip for you. If you stay that long, it's an extra tip to smile until you're actually happy. If you found this video insightful, like helpful at all, then make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. As I said, I'm here for psychology, spirituality, entertainment, music, tarot. I'm still trying to find my niche, and yeah, you can check out my other videos if you want to. But for now, I wish you a wonderful day, and goodbye.